And go. Back out.
I've lived in Los Angeles since 2006. And Cole and I and our friend Oscar moved here. And then because we didn't know where else to go, because everywhere else seemed really lame. And it seemed to us that the best music ever was coming out of LA at the time. And so we felt like we should move there because that's where it's coming from. And it also seemed sort of unpopular to live there, at least from our perspective, being outside. And so we thought maybe it would be less expensive.
I've lived in Los Angeles almost my whole life. I was born in Wisconsin, and I was brought here by my parents, but I've actually chosen to stay here because I like it. I really like how LA is really spread out, so everyone has their kind of space to do, recreate all the things in their imagination. At the same time, you can kind of build a scene of a sort of community with musicians or artists or whatever, but you can also kind of have your own space.
Definitely the juxtaposition of doom and hope is something that inspires me, because I was just talking to my friend Sam actually about how we were driving into Topanga and it was really brown over LA, and that's just one of those things that is kind of Paradise Lost, but if you're going into the city and you are expecting such inspiration,
right?
But at the same time, it's sort of dismal.
It's hard to say in general what a whole city inspires, but especially one that's as spread out as LA. But I think that the song we did was inspired just by Topanga, specifically, which is a very specific part of LA, and it's foresty and this sort of inside outside, we're kind of outside while we're inside, and kind of incorporating the beauty of the forest into the room where we were writing the songs. But it's funny because when you say something so LA, it really just means that there's a lot of aspects to it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then it's complicated.
It's multidimensional. It's so LA.
Okay, I think that's it.
Thank you, Dubla.
Bye. Thanks,
bye.
Dubla.